Hey y'all, I'm James Wright. Welcome to my shop. Today, we're gonna be making a wooden screw, but without a screw cutting box. We're gonna cut this completely by hand and carve it. Ooh. Let's dive in. Now, a lot of you are gonna say, this doesn't look great. It's a bit of a mess right now. Yes, it is hand carved, it's fairly rough. And the reason we're not gonna clean this up is it's actually better to clean that up once you have the nut in place. So we're going to leave it fairly rough and we're going to make a nut for it on the next episode, but today we're gonna be focusing on making the threads because this is something that's all on its own. To do this, we're going to make it out of a 2-inch poplar dowel. And I'm going to grab a measuring tape for a seamstress. Someone who does fabric and sewing. This is just about the perfect spacing to wrap these around and leave a little bit of space for a pin to go in between. If I were to do it again, I think I would bunch them together a little bit more and tighten it up. But it is about 3/4 inch, and this is actually going to be a double thread. So every one of these lines is only half of the threads going around this. So we can follow one, and it gives me that perfect screw running all the way around it. You could just do this with a scrap of paper as long as it's the same thickness all the way around. Then I put a piece of tape on my carcass saw down to about 3/8 of an inch. Nothing particular here, somewhere between a quarter and 3/8 of an inch ish that. I put the tape on either side and it gives a very quick visual reference so I can cut down to the same depth every time. And so I'm going to clamp this in the vise and start cutting down all the way around these at that point. And so I can do the top section about a third of the way around and just keep going until I get really close to that tape. The depth doesn't have to be perfect because we're actually going to carve down a little bit deeper than this. Then we can stop, rotate it a third, and continue. And a lot of this process is just going to be the rinse and repeat. It is pretty simple in that you cut down a depth and then you come in with a V-tool and you carve it out. It's one of those things that there aren't a lot of steps to it, just, you know, it's going to be the same thing over and over again. So we're going to keep carving, cutting in all the way around this. Now, because this is going to be a double thread, I should probably come back through and cut a groove in between these, but I decided to actually try freehand carving it rather than following the groove in the second thread. So for this, we're just going to use a V-tool, and I'm going to go in pretty deep, which means I'm going to do 3 or 4 passes all the way around. And as you continue around this, you're going to have to continually rotate it so you're matching the new angle at every point. And that means the threads right now are just going to have facets. And that's okay. We're going to come back and clean them up later. We're not looking for perfect threads right now. And we're not going to take it down to full depth. I'm going to go down until the wings of my V-tool are just touching on both sides. And that way I get an even depth measured by the V-tool in the groove. So what we're going to do is we're going to start and do one, we're going to follow this line about 1/4 of the way around on the top here. You also notice it's clamped firmly in the vise rather than hanging out the end. It's just a little less vibration that way. I could get a little bit farther around each time if I put it out on the end, but I like the less vibration. So once I've come in on all of those grooves that we cut, I'm actually going to eyeball coming in the middle of it. And this is going to leave a little bit of a flat spot, about 1/8 of an inch in between each groove. And that's okay, we're going to be cleaning that out a little bit later. Gives it a little bit more of like a, what's the word I'm looking for? Like an Acme screw. So we can come in between each of those and eyeball the center of each one out. Again, you don't have to be precise at this point. We're just roughly getting them into place. We're going to make this into a screw in visual appeal rather than a screw in function as of yet. The screw in function won't actually come until we get the nut because the nut will tell us exactly where we need to clean off. It'll tell us where we're jamming and what we need to work on more. And that's actually what's more important. You'll notice that I'm also stopping regularly and stropping. You want to keep this as sharp as possible. I probably would stop every 4 to 5 minutes of this and then go back and strop it again. The more you do that, the cleaner your lines will be. At this point, you can start to see it's going to become a little bit monotonous. You're just going to keep going around this. And it was probably a good 30 minutes or so of saw work and carving work to get this down to where I wanted it. And it's going to take you even longer if you need a little more practice, but this is a great way to practice and a great way to learn. Anytime you're doing something over and over and over again, it's a great chance to learn. Now, I would say this is rather boring, but I actually enjoy it. And if I want to be correct, boring is done with a drill, a brace, and bit. So this isn't boring. This is carving. Just to make sure we're on the same page. But yes, just keep going around, and you'll notice that you start to get that standard feel of rotating the chisel as you go around, and you rotate the same amount every time because you're following the same radius, and it becomes something your wrist knows that every tap you move it just that little bit more to follow around. Some places here I'll end up going a little bit too deep. That's not a huge issue because we're going to be coming back and cleaning this up. As always, keep stropping it. But we're going to keep it rough because we can clean it up and just stay away from the lines. And well, actually, there's not any lines. We're not going to take it down all the way to depth. We're going to leave that little bit of flat spot on all of the faces. And we're almost to it. Now, once you get back to this edge, everything starts to get exciting because you're tying back into what was there before. And it's nice to actually see that the lines match up and you can fare out the curvature from one to the other, making sure you get a nice clean transition. You'll notice that they do look a little bit faceted. That's perfectly fine. That's just part of the way it is at this point. Once we get the nut, we'll actually be able to adjust and clean them out. The starting bit coming in, I ended up coming in with just a regular chisel and cleaning that up. That allows you just to hit that starting edge as it leads into the screw. I can do a little bit of cleanup work with a triangular file, but we're going to do a lot more of this later once we have the nut. This will allow you just to hit some of those main facets that are sticking up that you know you're going to run into. So there it is, a little bit crunky, but we'll clean it up in the next video. So there you have it, a pretty rough screw, but that's okay. We're going to be cleaning it up with the next one. The next one, we're actually going to make a nut, and then we're going to do all of the filing to clean this up and get it down to shape. We do that afterwards because you can have some roughness in a wooden screw and it still work perfectly fine. Once you get the nut on there, you'll be able to find where all those hard spots are, and you can file those down and take off what you needed to rather than taking off too much. So come back next time and we're going to be making the nut because I do like going nuts. So I hope you like this video. If you do have any questions, comments, ideas, thoughts, snide remarks, throw those in the comments down below. I do like to read through all of those. Also, we're probably going to be making a video with making a thread cutting box at some point in the future. Though right now, I kind of like doing this. It's a little bit boring, but very fun. And also, I want to say a huge thank you to all of the patrons on Patreon, members here on the channel. Everyone scrolling over in the side is making this channel happen. Without supporters actually supporting the channel, we would not be here. So thank you for that. If you'd like to help keep the lights on and keep this channel going, you can find out more about Patreon in the description down below. Or you can click that little join button and become a member here on YouTube. So I think that's it for now. And until next time, have a wonderful day. No, I'm not going to do that joke. And that is the first part of my Frankenstein costume.